Face masks have become an inseparable part of our lives. For more vulnerable groups, the right face mask could spell the difference between life and death. But with so many options, how do we choose the right one? You may ask yourself, does my cloth mask really protect me? What if I can't sustain buying disposable masks? I'm Michelle.
And I'm Michael. And today we're going to look at different kinds of face masks. Mas kakaririn natin ang pag-alam, how effective they are, and how to properly use them. But wait, how does COVID-19 spread again?
The novel coronavirus spreads mainly from person to person through droplets expelled when infected persons sneeze, cough, talk, or raise their voices. These droplets can land or end up in the mouths or noses of people nearby, who could possibly inhale them into their lungs. Infected people who don't show symptoms of COVID-19 like the loss of sense of taste, dry cough, or fever could still spread the virus. That's why, among other safety measures, masks are essential. But wait, how do face masks work? Do they protect the wearer or the people around?
Good question! According to the US Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, or CDC, a mask offers some protection to the wearer, but it mainly prevents the wearer from spreading the virus to others.
Dr. Norberto Francisco, head of research at the Lung Center of the Philippines, says droplets will be filtered at the level of your mouth if you're wearing a mask, so the virus wouldn't be able to spread. If there are 10 of you in one place, everyone should be wearing one. If even one person doesn't wear a mask, COVID will spread if that person is infected. The N95 mask, meanwhile, protects the wearer. Because it's tight-fitting, it's harder for outside particles to reach the wearer.
Okay, suotin ko yung surgical mask para makita natin yung difference. So, dapat hindi nahawak sa harap. Tapos konting adjust para ano, swak sa mukha ako. Pero kahit na medyo swak na siya ng keso nang wala, may mga gaps pa rin na hindi maiwasan, 'di ba? Yan ito. So kapag may infected na nandiyan sa tabi, tapos bigla siyang umubo or kaya nag-hatching sa akin, tapos may lumusot dito na droplets, hindi malaki yung chance na baka pwede pa rin ako ma-infect.
Ngayon tingnan natin yung mangyayari kapag susubukan naming ihipan yung kandila. Okay, Michelle? Game. So see, wala nangyari sa kandila kasi walang lumalabas na hangin mula sa mask namin papunta sa kandila.
We can see here that the water doesn't go through the surgical nor the N95 masks.
So nakita nating N95 masks and surgical masks work pretty well in both the candle test and the water test. But how about cloth masks tulad ng suot ko ngayon?
An August 2020 study in Duke University finds medical masks offer significantly more protection against droplet spread than cotton alternatives, while bandanas protect less, and neck fleeces don't do much at all. The study reveals different masks eliminated droplet spray by the following percentages, from best to worst. Neck fleeces, meanwhile, are found to expel more droplets than with no mask at all, probably by dispersing the largest droplets into many smaller droplets. So it isn't true that anything is better than nothing. The World Health Organization says cloth masks should ideally have three layers. The inner layer should be hydrophilic, which means it absorbs droplets easily. So when you're coughing, this layer absorbs droplets and makes sure they stay in the mask and not go towards people around you. One example is cotton. The WHO advises it should be a light color like white, so you can see easily if it's soiled or wet. The middle layer should act like a filter between the inner and outer layer. The WHO says the ideal middle layer is a strip of polypropylene fabric. Some reusable shopping bags have this kind of fabric. The outer layer should be a hydrophobic material, the opposite of the inner layer. That means the fabric repels droplets and moisture. This can be made of a synthetic material like polyester or a polyester and cotton blend. Now that we know what makes a good mask, let's go into how to use masks correctly. Place the mask carefully, making sure it covers the nose and mouth, and minimize gaps between the face and mask. Avoid touching the mask while wearing it. When removing it, don't touch the front of the mask, but untie it from behind. Do not reuse single-use masks. Discard single-use masks after each use and dispose immediately. After removal, disinfect your hands with alcohol or wash your hands. So there we have it, Masks 101. We hope that this video has been informative and useful.
Follow Rappler for more explainers and information about the coronavirus.